In this illustration, we intend to simulate an earthquake of 6.5 magnitude on the Richter scale applied to a concrete dam in the Abaqus software. In this picture, you can observe the proportions of the dam. It is 103 meter high, and the height of the water behind the dam is 91.75 meter. In the above diagram, the transverse ground acceleration records, and in the diagram underneath, the vertical ground acceleration records can be observed. Actually, the transverse and vertical ground acceleration records are applied to the dam during the earthquake, and here the earthquake duration is 10 seconds. Then I click on Add Dimension, put this side as 70 meter, the size of this side as 103 meter, this side as 14.8 meter. Consider the vertical distance between these two points as 36.5 meter. And between this point and this line as 19.25 meter. In the next step, I'll select damping from the mechanical menu. Here we intend to enter beta coefficient. Beta will be considered in the formula in such a way that it will be equal to 2 zeta 1 divided by omega 1. Omega 1 is the first natural frequency that is equal to 18.61 radian per 1 second. Zeta 1 is also a fraction of critical damping for the first mode and is equal to the same quantity of beta, means 3.23 multiplied by 10 to the power of negative 3 second. I'll enter the quantity of 3.23 multiplied by 10 to the power of negative 3 and click on OK. I'll click on Create Step. In the third step, we intend to simulate the process of earthquake. Here, I'll select Dynamic Implicit, Continue, and consider time period as 10 seconds. In the next step, I intend to enter the hydrostatic water pressure of the water reservoir that will be applied to the upstream of the dam in the Abaqus software. I'll click on Create Load. Here, I'll select hydrostatic pressure step. From here, pressure, continue. Then select this line and this one and done. I will select hydrostatic in the distribution section. The hydrostatic water pressure applied to the upstream of the dam is calculated as observed in this picture. I'll enter this quantity here as 900,068 Pascal. Then I'll enter the Excel software and select these two columns. Click on Write. Copy and paste, and then click on OK. Here I will select the transverse ground acceleration as well, and OK. Click on seed edges, select this line, this one, and this line. Consider 20 elements for it, and OK. I'll select this line and this one and consider two elements for it as well. Well, here I am going to draw the horizontal displacement of the crest of the dam relative to the ground. To do so, I will click on Create XY Data. From here, ODB field output, continue. Then I will select U1 here. Then click on Edit Selection. Select the crest of the dam. Click on Done, and after that, click on Plot. Save and OK. Here I will rename the diagram to Crest and OK. In the next step, I will select this node and click on Plot. Save that and OK. Now I will also rename this diagram to Ground and OK. In the next step, I will click on Create XY Data again, then on the Operate on XY Data, continue. Here I will select this diagram, then the subtraction or the same minus operator. Then I will select this diagram and click on Plot in this manner and save that. In the next step, I will click on Create XY Data. Operate on XY data once again. Here I will select this diagram and multiply that by 1000 and plot. Then I will double click on the vertical axis of the diagram and rename that to displacement millimeter, since the unit for displacement is millimeter here. As you can observe, the maximum displacement of the crest of the dam relative to the ground is about 40 millimeter, which has been determined here clearly.